And I think it's really messed up that they're going to have to change the end of the Flintstones theme song just because of Florida. You got it? Do you get it? Yep. You got it, but you didn't. You didn't get it. Yeah, now you got it because she told you, yeah. How about up there? Y'all get it? Okay. All right, that's enough time. And as I said, you know, I live in New York, and I'm fucking thrilled that I get to raise a kid in that environment and not have the shitty fucking childhood I did. And you know, we live in a very diverse neighborhood, culturally, economically, ethnically, you know, and she goes to a great school, public school. She goes to a public school down the street. It's awesome. And she's in the minority. She's in the minority at that school. And I mean, don't freak out. She has white friends, you know. We insisted upon it, but no, it's awesome. And you know, she's learning all these great, and here, I gotta read this to you, okay? This is like from about 6-7 weeks ago, right? So this wasn't in the set when I first started, but this is true. This is what I'm about to read to you is for real, okay? This is Florida. If you want to see the outcome of Ron DeSantis' Stop Woke Act, look no further than changes made to a first grade social studies text about Rosa Parks. Okay? So, here's the old version. This is what they were teaching kids in Florida. The law said African Americans had to give up their seats on the bus if a white person wanted to sit down. Well, that's pretty much what it was, yeah. But that was no good because the beautiful, fragile children of Florida, when they heard this, they started committing suicide en masse. So they had to change it. So they changed it to, she was told to move to a different seat because of the color of her skin. All right, well, not as specific, but also true. That's fine. No. That wasn't. It was still an issue, even after they changed it, and these precious, precious youngsters were, when they heard this news, they all started doing heroin and joining the Church of Satan. So they changed it. They changed it again. And what I'm about to read to you is what they are teaching kids in Florida about the Rosa Parks story. Ready? Here you go. She was told to move to a different seat. She did not. She did what she believed was right. The Rosa Parks story. Yep. And you notice how they leave a little wiggle room there, right? For the homeschoolers. She did what she believed was right. You know, with it wasn't right, you know. She did what she believed was right, and it just sounded like somebody was getting too big for their britches, and, getting all uppity and causing a fuss, and she should have just listened to her superiors and moved to the back, but she didn't. She did what she believed was right, and now we got to deal with all these vape stores. The Rosa Parks story. Hey kids, we're going to learn about Martin Luther King Jr. today. Martin Luther King Jr. told us all about a dream he had. But everyone knows it's boring when people tell you their dreams. He was rude and insolent. Nonetheless, a kindly white gentleman by the name of James Earl Ray was so moved by Dr. King's dream speech that he decided to give him a present. And he looked around his house. What can I give Dr. King? I know what I'll give him. I'll give him these free bullets. But I'm so far away. How can I get them to him quickly? In Germany in 1939, a confused but well-meaning young man tried to come up with a solution to a problem that everyone had. He tried everything, and nothing seemed to work, so he was forced to use his final solution. And although there were very fine people on both sides, two wrongs don't make a right, Jews. Yeah. It's crazy.